It's time once again for that business show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ, where business becomes show business. Jamie is a leading Tampa Bay real estate agent and featured on the Wall Street Journal's list of top 100 real estate agents in the nation. Jamie invites you to list your home with him today and learn more at tampabayradio.com. Now, live in studio and promoting the entrepreneurial spirit that drives the American economy, your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Monday through Friday, 7 to 9 here on Tampa Bay's 1250 Winds WHNZ, and also video stream available over on tampabayradio.com. Joined in studio by the lovely Stella Giudicelli, also a real estate agent with Coldwell Banker. Stella, welcome back.
Thank you. Thank you.
And also Josh Vosda, who keeps an eye on the video stream over there and who now tries to pair up our guests with a celebrity lookalike. So I know he's fast at work over there with our next guests.
So they're nervous now. Start.
A new segment to the program. So you got to watch the video stream to see the actual pairing. But we have Melissa Trinidad and Bridget Donovan, co-founders of Holy Fit. And it is holyfit.tv is the website. And this is an on-demand type of training product. And they're going to explain that to us throughout the segment. But first, let's just start with the basics. Bridget, how did you and Melissa meet and become business partners?
Well, actually, I had just moved to Tampa when Melissa and I met. I had brought my kids to Kate Jackson Park. My son was about to start kindergarten at Gorey Elementary, and that's where I met Melissa.
And Melissa, do you attest to that statement?
Yes, I can attest that statement is true. And as a matter of fact, during that meeting, I was in a tree with my daughter, up high in a tree, and they had just recently moved from England. So her son comes running up to the tree and goes, "Hello up there." And then shortly thereafter, Bridget comes running up, and I look down at her and I say, "Hey, I'm not a predator. I have a daughter myself. I'm not just hanging out in a tree randomly."
So you still got the child and you're still climbing the trees.
Yes, young at heart, you know, always be a kid. But just a couple months later, when the school year started, our kids happened to be in the same kindergarten class.
I was a tree climber too. I built tree houses, and I was, you know, in my younger days. Stella, were you a tree climber?
I don't remember that now.
I don't see Stella climbing into the trees.
So. Yeah, but Melissa was actually the very first person I met in Tampa.
Yeah.
And that our children went to kindergarten class together and then had their desks.
It was meant
together.
To be, huh?
Mm-hmm. A match made in heaven, so to speak, should we say. Now, you both own your own individual businesses. So, Melissa, I will start with you. Tell me a little bit about your background and your business.
The name of my personal business is Optimal Health and Performance Training, and I provide services in personal training, group training, corporate wellness. And it just has evolved. I've been in the industry for 13 years, and as a trainer, you know, previous to that, I was a collegiate athlete, amateur kickboxer, Golden Gloves boxer.
I knew it. She said kickboxing. Look who it really is. I don't know their names, but it's the Yellow and Pink Ranger from Power Rangers.
The pink is the most mighty. Oh my gosh, seriously.
So real.
I think this is spot on. Good call.
I'm never wrong. Never.
With my background in athletics and my passion for health and fitness, as I've matured through the years, you know, it's become more of not just an athletic-based thing, but wholeness, wellness as a whole. And then teaming up with Bridget has been the most spectacular thing because we share that same vision. And now we bring fitness to the community.
And you were also on a television program? What was that again?
I was on a... Well, besides the Power Rangers stint, I was also the season premiere winner of the American Gladiators comeback show in 2008.
Wow, congratulations on that.
So you can download me on iTunes and see you get my butt whipped.
Season one, what did that get you? What did you win for that? A big cash prize or just a big thank you and a trophy?
Bragging rights. Yeah.
Bragging rights and a scar on my forearm. Memories that will last a lifetime.
Is that show even still on anymore, American Gladiators?
It wasn't. It was big in the 80s. I watched it as a child. I absolutely loved it. And they came back in 2008 and 2007 for a comeback season. It was hosted by Hulk Hogan and Layla
Ali.
That's
right.
At the time.
That's right.
So what is it? I'm trying to.
She can tell you. Yeah.
Well, American Gladiators pits like just. Like your everyday athlete weekend warriors, and you go through a series of events where you battle against these giant beastly gladiators
with 80s hair
muscles, and you battle them out and you accumulate points, and at the end is a big
it's like gym class for the extreme athlete.
Yeah,
or whatever.
It sounds tough. It is. You swim under fire. You climb up a cargo net. You run up all these obstacles. It was totally insane and totally awesome.
Cute tiny you made it.
Yeah. Number one.
Yeah, I did. It was an amazing, it's amazing mental, event. Right?
Like, but with all the events, mentally, they're pitted up against a gladiator, yes, who is, yeah, in opposition,
I was,
to them.
For,
yes,
example, one of the people I was pitted against, her name was Helga. And she was ginormous and scary, but you know, going toe to toe with that kind of, you know, obstacle in front of me—that's where I thrive. I, yeah, love that kind of stuff.
Yeah, but you won the season there, so,
yeah,
congratulations!
I won the season premiere, and it was a wonderful experience, wow, being out in LA and living out a childhood dream.
Awesome! Congratulations, mm-hmm, on that.
Thank you,
Bridget. Tell us a little bit about your background and your business.
Sure. Well, my background's in digital media and interactive e-learning, interactive development. And I've had the wonderful opportunity of working with some really creative, dynamic people throughout my career, and seeing very creative projects come together. My business is called Media Ecology, and I create branded websites, short-form stories, full-service video production, and interactive e-learning.
Did we find her lookalike yet? No?
No.
Okay. Go ahead. Now, you're also an award-winning producer and director on top of your business as well. So tell us about that.
Correct. So much of my background has been in creating video-rich learning resources. So a lot, oftentimes that means, you know, producing full-on video series. And that's what Melissa and I have done together as well. So I've taken, you know, my skill set in video production and delivering that through an online platform, whether that's the internet or some other type of learning platform that are very popular in corporate settings or academic settings. But basically creating learning content that people can, you know, learn, transform across all sorts of topics. And very frequently that involves video. So
what's how do you make videos? Are you the one actually filming the videos?
I've taken a variety of different roles. I would say I'm mostly a producer.
Okay.
So I'm basically bringing things together, lots of ideas, concepts, creative idea development, conceptuals, and then, you know, bringing a team of experts together. So many times that involves, you know, cameraman or camera operator, camera woman. Sometimes that involves a different director, but I've often directed video productions myself as well.
Okay, so Holy Fit TV is an on-demand fitness and training, so to speak. Am I getting that right?
Correct.
Okay, so you're running basically the video and the production, and then Melissa's running the fitness part of it, correct?
Yes, so okay. Melissa and I teamed up, and we, you know, combine our skill sets to create new products and services that benefit people's lives and, you know, provide healthy avenues.
So how did the idea get its start? Where did y'all see this vision? How did this come together?
Well, Holy Fit started from a very personal place, and it's a very personal story, but just to keep it brief, I was having a conversation with my daughter one evening, tucking her into bed, and she was encountering some problems. So I said, you know what, why don't we close our eyes, we'll pray about it. And she said, why would we do that? There is no God. So that really kind of struck a chord. Not that I'm deeply religious, but I grew up Catholic and with those, you know, moral backgrounds and such. So the next day we were driving down the street, and luckily there was a Baptist church there, and it had a sign, a marquee, and it said, Google doesn't always have the answers, which was such great timing. It was totally kismet, you know, because then from there she was like, well, what does that mean? And I said, well, what did we discuss last night? So at the same time, I was working with a client of mine, Debbie Anderson, military vet, and also a member of Harvest Time Ministries International. We would train, and she would come in, she would talk about the bake sale and how all this women's group she was working with at the church really wanted to lose weight. And I said, you know what? Why don't we replace the bake sale? Why don't we come in? Bridget and I will do a fitness event. We filmed it. I was like, wow, this is something we could share with people. This is something that we could do not just with church communities, but with membership-based communities. And so that's how Holy Fit really began. And then from there, we were like, well, let's combine our skill sets. Let's deliver online streaming exercise programming. And it grew from there, because not only do we offer services in digital fitness programming, we also are corporate wellness providers. We work for Emmy Wilson Risk Management. And we also do special events. We host fitness events, such as the Gasparilla Stand-Up Paddleboard Invasion. So if there's a fitness solution out there, we will provide it for you.
So people can then go to the website again, holyfit.tv. Do they register and pay a membership fee to have access to the courses, or how does this work for, you know, people that are interested in, you know, on-demand training?
Well, if people are interested in on-demand training, they can go to holyfit.tv, and we have the core collection currently available. It's a monthly subscription of $14.99 a month, and there's a 12-week training program that's completely body weight. It requires no equipment except your own body and an internet-connected device. Okay.
No gym equipment is required, no bands, no weights.
Nope.
It's a whole body workout.
And there's an incredible variety of exercises.
Yep, tell us. Okay, you got like 7-minute abs worked in there somewhere?
The collection is a series of 4 videos where we have upper body, lower body, core, and de-stress and stretch, which is our yoga stretching video. And this is all based on the principles of exercise science. So yes, these are great programs, but what makes them effective is that they are based on exercise science. So we have different levels of progression. We have a beginner, an intermediate, and advanced version of each exercise, and everything is based on time. So the beginner would work for 30 seconds, the intermediate exerciser for 45, and the advanced for 60. And then throughout the program, the 12 weeks, it's accompanied with worksheets that you could track your progress over time. They're run time videos. So if you can imagine P90X, but only better, online, featuring Bridget and myself and everyday people. And that's the great thing about our videos, is that they are shot beautifully in Tampa locations that you will immediately recognize. The rooftop of the Floridan. It looks like we're doing yoga floating in the air. I mean, these videos are gorgeous and trackable, and it also has the time clock on there, so you know exactly how far along you're working.
So a 12-week program to get you back into shape. How often do you change the videos up? Say somebody wants to go back through it again. They're going to see the same videos. Is there a plan to kind of refresh these videos every so often, every year or two? What's the plan for that?
Yeah, so really, Holy Fit is ever evolving a fitness solution, and it's dynamic. So new videos will be added. We have more videos in production right now, and when those are complete, we'll be offering a full bodyweight series, which has even more videos. I think we have balance and some other episodes.
Kickboxing.
Yes. And you can there's more to come.
And you can see all about this over at the website holyfit.tv. Currently talking to the co-founders, Melissa Trinidad and Bridget Donovan. You're listening to That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, your business becomes show business.
Tampa Bay, available everywhere you want to listen on our free iHeart.
How many times have you said to yourself, I wish there was an app for that? Stop wishing and start making the world better. Turn your brilliant idea into a profitable business by using Popcorn Apps. Their affordable app design will help get your blue sky idea or proven business to the next level at a fraction of the cost of other developers. They will help you get through all the steps needed to make your thoughts become live. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn, or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a $1 million business and a world changer starting today.
Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is 1, upfront pricing, 2, clear deadlines, 3, personally available year-round, and 4, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit taxhappens.com for more information. So Tampa Bay weather is a roof killer. That's why when getting your roof done, you want it done right. Hi, I'm Jamie Maloney of That Business Show. When considering a new roof or repair, talk to Westfall Roofing. They've been installing high-quality roofs in Tampa Bay for over 25 years. Get a free, no-obligation estimate by calling 855-99-ROOFING. That's 855-99-ROOFING. Find out what already 15,000 satisfied customers already know. Call now, 855-99-ROOFING.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their Shop at Home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made well-born cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at YeagerFlooring.com.
If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Tasseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktasseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Tasseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Good morning. Crash in St. Pete on Dr. King at 77th Avenue North. Also slow traffic on southbound I-75 from just north of Fletcher to I-4. Westbound I-4 continues to be slow from Plant City over towards Branch Forbes and the southbound side of the Veterans Expressway. Only slow between Wilski and Waters. See traffic problems. Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Utrecht. Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line 866-545-9595.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And we're back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Talking to the co-founders of HolyFit.tv, Melissa Trinidad and Bridget Donovan. So, Melissa, tell me, why is the Tampa community so important to you?
Well, the Tampa community is so important to me. With my background, I come from a military family, and we moved around a lot. Nowhere, you know, very sexy. It was all throughout the Midwest. So when I came to Tampa...
Someone right in between now and then.
So when I moved to Tampa in 99, and I ended up having a daughter in 2001, it was really important for me to establish those roots. You know, she grew up in, you know, the South Tampa area. Now we live along the river, and the community is so important because I want to make it a better place for my daughter and for all of our kids, you know, and tying that into health and fitness, my passion and spreading that throughout the community. It's such an important tie-in for me because I want to make it the best place possible for future generations.
Bridget, why is Tampa so important to you?
Well, Tampa's a great place to be, and I've felt that way about it since the minute I moved here, actually. And it's really exciting being a part of its progression right now. It's experiencing such economic development, everything happening along the Riverwalk, the way that the mayor's transformed all the parks, how we have it's a access to all of these wonderful pieces of outdoor life, and you can really create a healthy lifestyle here. In addition to that, there are a lot of families in this community that have businesses and that support these local initiatives, such as some of the things that we do.
So tell us about the Gasparilla Stand-Up Paddleboard Invasion. What is this, and when is this?
Well, the Gasparilla Stand-Up Paddleboard Invasion is a stand-up paddleboard race that Bridget and I started hosting 2 years ago. It's now an annual event and part of the season of Gasparilla. It was started out of our love for stand-up paddleboarding. It's the fastest-growing sport in Florida. You could do it anywhere. And then with the advent of Tampa's Riverwalk, we just saw an avenue to promote what we love in an area that we love to be in, and now it's accessible to
I've always heard of stand-up paddleboarding, but I'm hearing more and more about it in the last few years. Why is it a growing trend in fitness?
Well, it's a great total body workout, but especially in Florida, it's booming because you could do it all year round. You could do it in the rivers, you could do it in the ocean, you could do it in the bay. It's accessible, and like we were saying with the Riverwalk, with all the different parks of Okeechobee Fort Brooke Park and Waterworks Park, we now have access to the river. And what's so great about it is that anyone can go out and do it, all level of difficulty, from the beginner to, you know, the advanced racer.
Is there a learning curve to it? I mean, when somebody gets on the paddleboard, do they fall over a time or two? Yeah. Or is it pretty much...
It's got to be challenging balancing just the balance.
Well, the boards are kind of big. Yeah. And so
it comes quickly, though, right?
Yeah, it's great for your core. It can come quickly with the right instruction, right? So come paddle with us sometime. go ahead, Melissa.
Yeah, so we started this race, and, you know, we love Gasparilla. We love Tampa. I mean, we love Tampa, and just tying it into the season of Gasparilla was just a natural fit for us. combining everything that we love in the community with the sport we love and the message that we want to bring, it was just the perfect avenue for us to promote a healthy lifestyle throughout the Tampa Bay area.
So when is the event? Is it during Gasparilla's season, or is it coming up anytime soon? When is the event?
This year, it took place during Riverfest, okay, which is the first weekend of May. So we're looking to those dates for next year. So it will be in the spring towards the end of the Gasparilla season.
Interestingly enough, mm-hmm, I found out from other people that Gasparilla is not, anybody can take that name for events and stuff. I talked with people who run the Gasparilla Music Festival, asked them if it was tied to the season. They're like, no, it's a Gasparilla. Anybody can take that name if they want to use it for an event or something. So interestingly enough, I thought that would be branded, you know, or somehow trademarked.
It's a well-known name.
But no, it is. And it makes people automatically think it's associated like with the Gasparilla Parade. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's got huge brand loyalty. Yeah. And it's really cool, you know, that there are so many different types, the way that Gasparilla has expanded into movies and art and interactive. And one of the fun things that we did this year was take the presenters of the Gasparilla Interactive Conference out paddleboarding. So it was kind of like, you know, tourism. They got to see the Tampa from the river, and it was a great experience, and we hope to, you know, work with other Gasparilla events as we continue.
Won't that attract the wrong crowd, though? Like a bunch of drunken teenage people trying to show everybody their boobs for beads and trying to just have a stand-up boat race, you know?
Well, perhaps, but, you know, I think the people who go into the Gasparilla Sup Invasion, a lot of the majority of our racers were first-timers. I mean, there are a lot of actually seasoned racers in Florida, but what was so great is that the draw of our race were people who were just interested in the sport. So it was a great first-timers event, and that's where we look to grow.
And that's also really a part of the, you know, essence of Holy Fit. We created Holy Fit. It was discovered in a community. It was discovered through, you know, a personal journey, and those connections with your social network. And part of what we believe as founders is that that's very important, you know, to the health and well-being of individuals, to feel connected and to find something healthy and active that you love. So we're very pleased to be able to put on events, even oftentimes we do free Holy Fit community workouts, just so that, you know, we don't want people to feel alone out there, and you want to find something that you're passionate about and find a community of people who support you and come out every day. And go ahead.
Yeah, and just, we couldn't do this without partnerships throughout our community. I mean, a lot of the events that we offer are free fitness events, and we couldn't do that without the support of local families who want to stir economic growth, such as the Hegarty family. So thank you, Maureen, out there.
And Robert.
Yes, and then, you know, bigger corporations such as T-Mobile, who've really connected us throughout the community.
Instrumental.
And, of course, Jimmy Lewis Boards, best board maker on the planet. I'm also a team racer and brand ambassador for Jimmy Lewis, but he's also a big sponsor of the Gasparilla Sup Invasion. And if it wasn't for our partnerships, we wouldn't be able to do this, and we're very thankful.
So when did you launch Holy Fit TV? How old is the brand now?
It's in 2014. Yes, 2014. I was looking at each other. Yeah, time passes so quickly.
It does.
Yes, 2014. So.
And where do you see the brand in 5 years? What's the long term plan for that?
Well, one of the exciting things, so kind of the shorter part of that. Not 5 years, but one exciting thing that we have just started is taking up an office in Ybor City.
Mm-hmm.
So we're very excited about that as part of the progression of our business and to be a part of, you know, such a historic place where Tampa's city in a city. And so that's what we're doing next. But as we continue to evolve, we'll have more service offerings through holyfit.tv. We'll continue to grow our corporate wellness side of the business.
Yeah, we foresee digital fitness programs, Holy Fit Kids, Holy Fit Games, a little bit more extreme kind of training, so a different array of digital fitness products. We're also working alongside Bob Enriquez with his campaign, so you could come see us and meet us tonight at the Hobnob.
All right, good information, and good luck with your project, holyfit.tv, from co-founders Melissa Trinidad and Bridget Donovan. Thank you both so much for being in studio.
Thank you for having us.
Yep, we'll be back in a moment.
Are you at retirement age, or are you...
We'll be right back. Hi, I'm Kelly Ham from Dillmeyer Ham Consulting. Did you know that one of the biggest challenges that leaders face is getting their employees to be engaged, motivated, and producing amazing business results? At Dillmeyer Ham Consulting, we'll help you transform your workforce culture from one that might be underperforming, maybe mediocre, to achieving amazing business results. You see, we realize that your workforce culture is equally as important as your business plan and your business strategy. The two must be aligned in order for you to reach your desired business and financial goals.
Hey, Carol.
Hey, Jim.
I just got this plan that could really help with our process here.
Okay, why don't you just have a seat and let's go over it.
Let us help you transform your workforce culture by leveraging your most important assets, your people. I want to know what's going on in your organization. Let us help you transform your workforce culture. Let's have a conversation.
I feel guilty that I can't always be there when Mom feels stuck at home. She was always there for us. But now she can't get out and I'm not always available to take her places. Someone else needs to help her get around. Then I learned about Home Instead. Now Mom can do what she enjoys because her personal caregiver is there. And I can just be a daughter again.
Are you struggling to care for your loved one? We can help. Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
50% more cloud cover, low 90s. Impact Radio 1250 Winds, WHNZ.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds, WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Monday through Friday, 7 to 9 here on Tampa Bay's 1250 Winds WHZ. Also, we run the live video stream over at TampaBayRadio.com. Also, want to invite everybody over to the website there. We've got a new partnership video up between me and the Tampa Bay business owners. So me and Chris had that produced here over the last couple of months. So you can kind of see the vision for what we have for the Tampa Bay business community entitled Join the Entrepreneurial Movement. Again, we'd like to get all the business owners working together and collaborating to bring a stronger voice to the Tampa Bay business owner. So again, watch our video, see the vision. If you're not a member of the Tampa Bay business owners, please reach out to myself or one of our leaders there and have a sit down with us and let us show you why the Tampa Bay business owners is Tampa Bay's premier business community. A lot of new benefits being added to the membership now, along with the partnership between myself and the Tampa Bay business owners, including an annual radio show appearance, and also working on live streaming the events. So the people that cannot attend, that's always the feedback that we get from people: oh, I don't have time to attend the events. So we're going to be working on live streaming the events for the membership. So if you got a reason, we're trying to eliminate all the different reasons why somebody would not want to join the group. And again, 8-year-old brand, 300 plus members in the organization, and a great way to collaborate, learn, and meet different people. And we have a May event coming up this Wednesday, August 3rd, here at the Center Club from 5 to 7:30. It is a membership-only event, but if you'd like to attend, we do invite guests out to the membership meeting one time free of charge. Just mention the radio show.
How much are the memberships?
$5.95 a year. $5.95 a year, and then a $2.50 activation fee up front, and you get a lot of different benefits for that. We do a lot of different educational events, main events, workshops, summits, the radio show, and a lot of little add-ons on top of that. So
awesome.
Very cost-effective investment to grow and learn and collaborate with other fellow business owners here in the area, and also get on the radio show as well. So big plans for the Tampa Bay business owners between me and Chris Kermitzos, who was the founder of the organization. We'll be talking a lot more about that tomorrow on TBBO Tuesdays. Time to bring in my next guest for the program. He is a returning guest of the program, Dominique Martinez, founder of Rustic Steel Creations. And if you've seen these different, you know, metal creations across Tampa, you know, from that big dragon that's on top of that building on Kennedy, and those soldiers that are alongside the road down Florida Avenue, and this big Brahma bull that seems to appear across the different areas of Tampa.
The door of Eulalie as well.
The door of Eulalie. He creates some amazing metal creations.
Wine cave.
Yes, all over.
Yeah, very interesting.
Dominique, welcome back to the program.
Thank you
today.
For having me, Jamie. Thank you.
So tell us, what's your latest project? You got so many different things that you're working on here in the area, but what's your latest project today?
One of the latest projects that we just completed is a large grouper fish that we're going to be delivering down to Anna Marie Island. It's for a restaurant called The Ugly Grouper. This thing is massive, 22 feet long, 10 feet wide, 14 feet tall. Hopefully it'll
Where do you get the ideas for these? I mean, where do you get the ideas for these types of creations? Do people come to you and commission these, or do you make? Obviously, when you started doing this, you probably had to kind of create some of these things from scratch and say, "Look what I can do for you." I mean, how did this all come about?
Well, listen to what the client's needs are, and basically just look at the concept of what their theme is for a restaurant, a hotel, or even whether it's corporate America or a private home. And the most important thing is that you get inside these people's minds, and it's like, okay, we want to do something that's going to be an eye catcher. We want to do something that's going to be a photo op for everybody. And I was like, wow. And it's like, okay, let's make the teeth out of GMC truck bumpers. You know, let's do the eyes out of, you know, Harley Davidson fenders, you know, things like that. And we put together a conceptual drawing. I have to hire an outside artist to do the drawings because I can't draw. I see things when they're done. And we put together a conceptual rendering and sent it off, and it's like, love it, love it, love it. And at the last minute, I even switched the teeth. Instead of putting them at the bottom, I put the buck teeth at the top. And the client was like, well, this is supposed to be rudimentary. And I'm like, no. And it's like, it's in our own, you know, perception. And he says, well, I want the teeth at the bottom. I'm like, okay. So we had to cut them out, re-weld them, and that's it. But the piece is definitely... an attention getter.
And you also offer creative welding classes over there. So people that are welders can come over and see how you do these types of creations.
The creative welding classes, it's really interesting because it's as long as you're 10 years old and above, we offer all the gases, the materials, the welders, the welding hoods, an instructor, a workstation. And you make a piece of art, and then you take it home at the end of the day.
Oh, so you actually make something.
Absolutely. And it's mainly working with scrap metal. But it's really grown over the years, and it's not something for us to make a bunch of money with. It's just something that we offer to the community because people, I mean, it's funny because we have a lot of attorneys and a lot of corporate individuals that come to the class as far as away from Miami. And then we put them up in a hotel. Well, they put themselves up in a hotel at a discounted rate in town, but... people love it, and it's just like, wow, it's really,
got a niche business. I mean, before I saw these creations, I remember a couple years ago, I started noticing these things. I was like, whoa, I'd never seen anything like that before. That was pretty creative. I mean,
we put out a lot. I'm really, really blessed to have the team that we have because, I mean, I'm very demanding, but my clients are even more demanding.
And you're over there off of what it's like, MLK and Highland. There. And
if you're driving by, you can't miss it.
Right. Yeah. And were you doing these before the last few years? I just started noticing these about a few years ago. Were you in this business before somewhere else? How did this come together?
No, I was down in Channelside, and I started in Channelside. And when I started, a friend of mine had a shop down the street. It was a brake and friction shop. And I said, wow, what a cool shop. And he was like, really? He's like, look, you can come in here anytime you want. He gave me the keys to the shop. And I would go in there at 2:30 in the morning, and I would work, and then I would leave at 9 o'clock. So this way I could be at work by 9:30. And after 3 weeks, I went to my manager, and I was like, look, I need some time off. And he says, you want time off? Take 10 minutes out in the hallway. You need more than that, leave. So I went to my office. I packed up my stuff and left without saying goodbye. And I never looked back.
Higher position, so you left that.
I was good money. It was good money, but it wasn't something I was passionate about. And you know, the mortgage I had was pretty steep, and I just quit, and I didn't have next month's mortgage.
Yeah, it was nowhere near the money you were making for the George Lopez show, was it?
Yeah, there's your looking like George Lopez up there. So you left your prior job pretty much on a whim there after a comment from the boss there. Were you a traditional welder? Did you have any experience in this? What drew you to this type of a business?
I was totally self-taught, and it's just when I started making things, it was using organic found objects, things like that. But designer John Bateman contacted me and says, hey, I heard that you work with steel. And I'm like, yeah. I said, can you make gates and railings? And I'm like, sure, not a problem. I never made a gate or a railing before in my life. And then the first house that I do is a 14,000 square foot home on Harbor Island at the Point. And
I'll figure it out as I go, right?
Jamie, it was so funny because I walked in with my portfolio of all these picture frames that I made. Not one picture of a gate and railing because I never did that. And the next thing you know is like I tuck it behind my back, and I had to borrow a tape measure from the carpenter to measure what I didn't know. And then next thing you know, that really put Rustic Steel Creations on the map.
But I feel that this is still how it is nowadays, right? Because when I speak with you, people come to you with requirements and asking you to be creative or telling you I need that. And like you just always, like it's so, no one has done it before. And this is, it looks like it's always what you do. It's like,
yeah,
look at things like, how am I going to make that happen? And you come with your solutions in your mind. And do you like that process where like you have no clue?
I love it because it pushes my envelope and I dig deep inside my mind of where the stuff comes from. I don't know. Typically at 2:00 in the morning, I wake up with my ideas and I text them inside my phone, you know, keep a log of, you know, creative ideas. When Richard Gonsmarth and Keith Sedita approached me about Ulele, I was, you know, it's like, oh yeah, I need some work done in my restaurant that I'm building. I had no clue, no idea what they were doing. I was like, okay, stainless steel fabrication inside the kitchen, boring. And then next thing you know, he's showing me this empty building with dirt on the floor. And I'm like, oh, and he goes, look, I want you to get creative. You know, giving you free reins to creativity, not the checkbook. And I was like, shucks. But next thing you know, I was, you know, it's like, are you kidding me? So we presented everything to Richard Gonsmarth and Keith and the chef Eric at the lunch table at Columbia. And Richard was like, I love it. I love it. I love it. Let's do it. And I even asked him, and says, how many front doors do you remember that you've touched in restaurants in the area that left that much of an impression? And he was able to name two, and I said, let's make Ulele third.
Yeah.
And everybody takes pictures in front of those front doors. Yes, we did the wine rack, we did the bicycle rack, we did the pizza oven door, all the table bases.
How do you say, the hood around?
The oven hood.
That was one challenging.
That was challenging. And, you know, and Richard loved everything. And, you know, him and Keith even made it in a statement, and it's like, yeah, Rustic Steel Creations and Dominique delivered the wow factor that they promised. And, you know, same thing with the Epicure and working with Joe Collier. We made a maquette of a large shun knife and fork. And it was like, wow, I love it. I love it. You know, and it's great. And we continue to work with Main Sales. We do with Ulele and a lot of other major corporations. Holy hog. I mean, this is something that I delved into with no construction background, no fabrication background, no welding experience.
You have your own tape measure.
I even have my own tape measure.
So do you find yourself having to hire artists and teach them welding or hiring welders and having to teach them art? I mean, how does that work?
It's, you know, what I find is that it's been really difficult process having an artist. It's like too many chefs in the kitchen, you know, and at the same time, it's just I want somebody that can be left brain and right brain working with me because the team that I have, they get me. Finally, they get me, and it took a long process. An artist will come in, they'll make something, and then it's just, you know, it just doesn't gel too well. A little bit of creativity, yes. But, you know, as far as all the designs, those are the things that I do. And then my guys have to make it. So in a sense, they're the true artists.
Now, do you all work on projects kind of like one at a time, sort of like, you know, with that motorcycle show where they're all kind of doing that one project together?
No.
Or do you all each just have your own little projects?
It's crazy when you go there. You have, so
each
much
of you
happening.
Got your own project going on?
We have 30, as of Friday, we have 33 projects going on simultaneously.
So you're definitely cranking them out over there. Wow.
We're busy. We're doing projects in New York. We're doing projects in Jackson, Mississippi, projects in Amory Island. A bunch of other projects throughout the Tampa area. And some of them are individual projects, some of them are for major condominium buildings in New York City.
Dominique, do you organize visits of your...
Yes, we have tours on a daily basis. We had to hire a front desk girl just to give out the tours.
Very cool.
Because I couldn't get up every 5 minutes or 10 minutes. And it's funny because people drive by and they're like, oh, what was the name of that company? And and this is a true story. People drove by and they saw this heart out front, this big 6-foot heart, and they passed it. And it was like, what was the name of the company? And they didn't get it. So we'll go back there after lunch. And they went to Ulele. And I was like, wait a second, this must be the same guy's work. And then they called us from Ulele. And it's like, are you the guy with the heart out front? And I'm like, yeah. So we're going to come by after lunch. And I'm like, okay. They came by after lunch, they bought the heart, and then a week later we delivered out to Coral Springs and installed it in their front yard. So things, it's ironic how things happen in life, and it's really quite amusing.
I love that story. You know, he was working in, you know, for just a regular 9 to 5, needed some time off. The guy said, take 10 minutes. If you need any more than that, don't come back. And he didn't come back. So
I was always a risk taker, and, you know, this was definitely taking a
and then, but you started
risk.
A business that was, you know, unlike any other business that one would think to start a, you know, a metal creations company here, and you've done tremendous amount. I mean, it's become like a staple of Tampa. I mean, you see your creations all over Tampa. So got to take a break here. Coming back from the break, I want to talk to you about Fire Station number 5, your latest project.
Cool.
Currently talking to Dominique Martinez, founder of Rustic Steel Creations, and you can see his creations over at rusticsteel.com. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
Attention medical
today. Who doesn't have a smartphone these days? And of course, there's an app for everything. Well, almost everything. That's why the folks at Popcorn Apps started developing mobile applications. They saw people like you with genius ideas unable to make those thoughts a reality. They develop applications for tens of thousands of dollars less than you'll find anywhere else and will turn your idea into a reality in a matter of just a few months. Think you're not ready? Think again. They are your one-stop shop for mobile application development. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn. Or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today. What's up, business rock stars? Are you ready to bring out the CEO in you? Join Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, every other Friday on That Business Show. She'll be talking with other chief entrepreneurial officers about how they grew their businesses. Remember, you could join the conversation at Focus on You Strategies Focus Fridays Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. That's facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. Be the CEO of you.
I knew Mom wanted to stay at home. It's the center of her family, her life. But helping Mom stay in her home while managing mine was just too much. Honestly, it wasn't just about me. Mom didn't want me to be her caretaker. She wanted me to be her daughter. I felt so alone until I found out about Home Instead Senior Care. When we met the people at Home Instead, we just knew they were different. The experience was personal. And most importantly, for Mom and me, I get to be her daughter again.
Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
At Vane 911, we will help you feel great again. Do you have restless legs, night leg cramps, or ankle swelling? Restless legs, cramping, swelling, and tired heavy legs are often symptoms of hidden vein disease. You do not have to have visible bulging veins to have the symptoms of vein disease. The vein care specialists at Vane 911 are uniquely qualified to evaluate and treat your veins. Are you unhappy with your previous vein treatment? Vane 911 succeeds where others fail. Call Vane 911 today at 855-VANE-911. That's 855-834-6911 to book your free consultation. Vane 911. We will help you feel great again.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Good morning, crash in Ellenton on westbound US 301 at I-75. Couple lanes blocked here and expect delays on westbound 301. Southbound 275 approaching Bush Boulevard. Delays there due to a crash just south of Bush in the right and center lanes and one on the exit ramp on southbound 275 to westbound Roosevelt. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Utrecht Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council. If you're dealing with the daily struggles of caring for a loved one, visit aarp.org/caregiving to find a community with experts and other caregivers who can provide advice and support. That's aarp.org/caregiving.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And we're back to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Talking to Dominique Martinez, founder of Rustic Steel Creations. Learn more, RusticSteel.com. Dominique, your latest project here, Fire Station number 5, what is this?
Yes, this has been a project that's been that's taken a great deal of passion, a lot of time, and money as well. It's been 7 years in the making. I purchased the fire. I found out about fire station number 5 right at the end of 2007, right around there, and purchased it from the city. I had to submit an RFP, request for a proposal, and I submitted the proposal and ended up winning the proposal. And I the day that I got the keys, I was like so excited. I ran through the building, and a friend of mine told me about the building. That's how I found out about it. And it's when you see it, your jaw will drop to the floor. A lot of city officials have been in there, and it's like, wow, wow, wow. I recycled everything that I could. It was a project that I was, I'm still passionate about. There's always something to do.
And so what are you turning it into? What is it going to become?
It's the back end of the fire station number 5 is called Red Door number 5. It's a gallery, and it's going to be featuring local artists, promoting local art throughout the state of Florida. And we're digging and looking for, you know, quality art that we can display and have showings in event galleries. And at the same time, the building, the entire building, is open for, it's a great venue space. I mean, it's absolutely, you'll see. And we just had one grand opening, and the whole opening went on without a hitch. And it was absolutely, I mean, it was breathtaking. It was just, it left me in awe. And we had Salt Block Catering do all the catering. Great company. We had music. I mean, there was so much going on, but it's the most important thing of all is that everybody comes into the fire station and they see, and it's like, wow, this place is so cool. Oh my gosh, we get compliments constantly because of the way that it's been renovated. It was decommissioned as a firehouse in 1984 because the trucks couldn't fit in anymore. And then it was turned into an office space for Metropolitan Ministries. Then it sat vacant. Everything in the building is new except the walls and the floors.
And what's where's it located at?
It's at 1910 North Florida Avenue.
So not too far from Eulalie.
Not too far from Eulalie. Not too far from my shop as well.
A lot of development in that area.
Yeah, a lot of
commercial and residential.
Going on.
Yeah, it's a good area.
And the tower goes up about 80 feet in the air. You have a 360-degree view.
Here's a good view of the tower up on the stream if you guys are watching.
Very nice. So is that after? I mean, is it already renovated? It's already done there in the picture?
Yep. We just finished painting the doors.
So the main room there up front is an event room. In the back is a display room for artists then?
Right.
Okay.
The gallery is going to be, it's a 2,000-square-foot gallery. But then we open up the residence portion because no matter, I said, no.
What did you do with the ghost containment unit?
We have Tampa Bay Ghostbusters that comes in every once in a while, and they do their investigation, so they always find something.
So how did Red Door get it started? How did you come up with this objective then?
When I purchased the property, when I put in my proposal, at the time it was Mayor Pam Iorio, who was in office, and my proposal was I just want to do a live-work art gallery space and promoting the arts. Pam Iorio, being a big fan with the arts and big supporter, really, you know, pushed it. And that's what this whole objective was. And plus, I was like, wow, how cool it would be to, you know, to live in a fire station. And, you know, every once in a while, I slide down the poles, you know, to go from upstairs to downstairs.
You do?
Oh yeah. It's
I
fun.
I want to be there when you do that.
Yeah. Now you mentioned residence, so there's apartments and stuff up top there.
No.
What just, did you mean by residence?
You meant the unwanted residence.
No, it's my private residence.
Okay, gotcha. Okay,
but it has a commercial grade kitchen. It has a bedroom and media room. It's about 1,600 square feet. It's got a outdoor deck, 2,000 square feet. It's got a patio area, about 1,500 square feet. The city was generous enough to give me over 8,000 Augusta blocks because of the restoration process of the building and the historic value to the building.
The Augusta blocks, the things the streets are made of in the old West Tampa. Papers, okay. And interesting.
It just really complemented the whole project. So
what type of events are you planning on having at Fire Station Number 5?
This is what's going to really, really be cool because, you know, everybody just keep an eye out because you don't want to miss this. I mean, the thing is that my whole objective, due to the fact that the building was built in 1925, let's bring back 1925 events. Let's look at all the different events that have been going in 1925, in that era, the Great Gatsby, the Roaring Twenties, Al Capone Nights, John Dillinger Night, Elliot Ness Nights, things like that. The Great Gatsby Nights and the Roaring Twenties Nights, people come in the nostalgic, you know, attire to, you know, even have some antique cars out front. The one night you do not want to miss is Prohibition Nights. That's for damn sure. That is, I'm not going to let the cat out of the bag, but it's going to literally turn into a speakeasy, and it's going to be a great deal of fun. Murder Mystery Night dinners. We're going to have pop-up dinners with Salt Block is going to be doing those and other catering companies as well. But it's something where I'm really, really excited. You know, there's so much going on right now. We can't keep up. There's so many inquiries coming. You know, our first event is going to be a Sweet 16 party coming up, I think in September.
You got something on the 23rd you'd mentioned. Is that a grand opening or an event kickoff?
Okay. Yes, that's going to be a grand opening kickoff. That's by invite only, sorry, because we can only fit so many people inside the building.
But these different events, are you going to be doing this like on a weekly, monthly type of basis, these different nights? Or
weekly, monthly, daily. You know, the gallery events will be featuring the local artists once a month. And during the month, we'll even take the art. Like, say, for instance, somebody wants to have a corporate event there with 100 people. We open up the entire building. We take the art. We spread it around the building so this way people can see the art in its natural form in a residence, you know, a private residence.
Sounds very fun. Are you already taking bookings for the room and selling tickets for this? How does all this? RusticSteel.com is your site for your creations. Do you have another site for this, or is there one in the works for that?
Yes. Tampa number 5, as in the number 5, .com.
Okay.
That the www.tampa.
Can you spell
Tampa,
these?
Yeah.
Tampa and then.
Tampa NO5.
Okay.
TampaNO5.com will be the website for this new firehouse there that you've.
That is literally in the works, but you can contact Nikki at TampaNO5.com.
All right. Another great development coming here to the Tampa region, thanks to Dominique Martinez, founder of Rustic Steel Creation. So, Dominique, thanks again for coming in studio.
Thank you very much for having me, Jamie.
Absolutely.
Really appreciate it.
And also thank you to Stella Giudicelli. Great show. Thank you for stopping by this morning, Stella.
Was fun.
And as always, thank you to Josh Foster, running the live video stream, available as always over on TampaBayRadio.com. Again, learn more about Dominique over at RusticSteel.com as well. Also, thank you to my guests there in that 8 o'clock segment, the founders of Holy Fit TV, website HolyFit.tv, co-founders Melissa Trinidad and Bridget Donovan. Please learn more about this program over at TampaBayRadio.com and also connect with me on all the different social media sites. You'll find me on pretty much every platform, and I'll see you back in here tomorrow morning on That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.